April, well, some airmen from the 172nd Security Force are finally back home tonight.
Yeah, those men and women were in Baltimore when Superstorm Sandy hit, stranding them for 2 days. 16 WAPT's Meg Pace is live tonight at Thompson Field, where the airmen arrived a few hours ago. Meg.
Darren, Stephanie, this plane here behind me took off from Thompson Airfield, which is where we're standing right now, at 9 o'clock this morning and headed straight to Baltimore to pick up those men and women of the 172nd who were stranded in the middle of Sandy's mess. As soon as the massive plane broke through the clouds, cheers erupted from the crowd on the ground. Friends and families rushed to the plane as soon as the first airman appeared in its doorway. This is a homecoming 2 days overdue. The 26 men and women of the 172nd Security Forces Squadron hadn't seen their families in 8 months. They're returning home from a deployment to Afghanistan when Superstorm Sandy stranded them in Baltimore.
We launched an aircraft here out of the 172nd Air Wing and went up and picked them up and brought them back home.
These 2 days stuck in Baltimore were two more days senior airman Patrick Jackson had to wait to meet his new son.
What's it like holding him for the first time? It's
unexplainable. You can't explain it. It's like best feeling in the world right now.
2 days that felt too long to these airmen and their families.
Hug him. I like.
We're going to let him stay up there long.
Now, while the squadron was in Afghanistan, they were stationed in Bagram, and they completed security missions for other units there. But tonight, they are at home with their families. Reporting live from Thompson Airfield, Meg Pace, 16 WAPT News.
We love to see those homecomings. All right, Meg, thank you so much. Well,